My name is Sange Mpambani. Sange is a queer black from the rural Siviwe, but I'm currently living here, Grahamstown and Cape Town. So Sange is a firstborn of four younger brothers. That's me. That is me. I do interdisciplinary work. I do theatre, dance, visual art, painting. That's me. Before I go to these places, before I dwell, because I'm really engaging with colonial history. So I start by, telling my ancestors that I'm dwelling in these spaces. So when I go to the sites, the performance that I'll be doing, I'm taking this body, I'm taking the role of a domestic worker as a queer black man, and a role of a domestic worker to a site, a taxi rank. And there are a lot of ruptures that happen within that space, because there's black masculinity, it's very much of black masculinities in taxi ranks. Taking my body there and also exploring with this idea of dwelling and how this continuing racism, this system racism, black masculinity kind of erupt, and all of the political things that happen kind of erupt when people, especially black men who work in that space, how they kind of receive this work. How forms of identification, radical recognition, because Ruth Simbao speaks about this thing of radical recognition, how my actions kind of erupt those things, because that's another form, that's also how psychogeography, like this concept of psychogeography works. It also works in terms of how the audience, how they receive this work.
The intention was to erupt reaction from the audience, a radical reaction, as Sange mentioned, but instead, people stood there and stared, wondering why he chose to bath with cold water. They perceived him as poor and hungry, which was a completely unrelated concept from what Sange was trying to convey.
Yeah, I think this is a process actually, because my work, I think people don't realize it now. You only realize it when you maybe sit down with it and kind of reflect on what you kind of saw. So yeah, I think I did create, because in terms of how people reacted to this, like the reactions, yeah, Pambana, Uraiti, and Oko, that's how things kind of erupt, like people kind of recognizing these things, like we are Pambana and Tonton and everything. So if they sit down with it, then that's when they kind of realize, or yeah, realize the work, because my work, you can't really recognize it or realize it now up until you kind of sit down with it, then reflect back, I think. But I just hope they, you know, have done my work.
Our greatest weakness lies in giving up, and Sange chose to rise up once again and retell his story. Breaking the silence was crucial in confronting his past traumas, as this was a way for Sange to reclaim his identity.
So, my performance first is reclamation of self. Reclamation of what I lost, and also trying to go back to who I was when I was, you know, when I was still very young, very feminine. A lot of my work, if you've noticed, like, is drawing kind of to black women. Like, there's an element of femininity in my performance. It's going back to who I was before people started identifying me, like when people started, you know, telling me who I am before I actually, you know, was able to put into, you know, to express myself. Even though I knew who I, you know, who I was, but people started to like make me move away from that because they couldn't understand who I was. Then my art really goes back to who I was. That's what African spirituality also is, because in this sense as me, as a queer person, going back to my queer self, my young queer feminine self. A part, aspect of my work is looking at the gaze, what people, the view, like what people perceive when they see a black man wearing this. In this performance particularly, I directly recite words. So I think that's also something that helps to maybe because now I'm kind of confronting you to think.
I refuse to die at the altar with my hands up and legs open. I refuse to die at the altar with my hands up and legs open. My silence couldn't protect me. Your silence will not protect you. These are the memories of a black queer slave. These are the memories of a black queer slave. My acts against oppression are integral with self. My acts against oppression are integral with self. With self. My acts against oppression are integral with self. With self. These are the memories. These are the memories of a black queer slave. These are the memories of a black queer slave. I refuse to die with my upper legs open. I refuse to die with my legs up. I refuse to die. I refuse to die. These are the memories. The memories. The memories. The memories. The memories of a black queer slave. These are the memories of a black queer slave. Refuse to die at the altar with our hands up and legs open. We refuse to die at the altar with our We will not die at the altar. These are the memoirs of a black queer slave. Honey. These are the memoirs of a black queer slave. We refuse to die at the altar. We will not die at the altar. We will not die at the altar. We will not die at the altar with our hands up, legs open.
I refuse to die at the altar, with my hands up and my legs open. These words speak to Sange's experience at church during his childhood, where he was subjugated to hiding his identity, and now he has finally gained the courage to confront those who silenced him.
Silence will not protect you. These are the memoirs of a black and queer slave. These are the memoirs of a black and queer slave. I refuse to be silenced. For this performance particularly, I directly confront them by saying, my acts against oppression are integral with self, motivated and empowered within. These are the memoirs of a black queer slave. I refuse to die at the altar. I refuse to die with my hands up and legs open. My silence couldn't protect me. Your silence will not protect you. So your silence will not protect you because it will not protect you because you know that there's a queer person in your related to you, and you know the things that they go through. You know, especially from black communities, they know that they are, these persons are very much oppressed, subjugated, like people do, like have, you know, comments, and you are silent about that, knowing very well what is going on. So your silence as someone who's related to that person will not protect you. So start speaking.